Run through the eyes of the dead, and you're getting your fix on metal fucking injection!
Rob here with Through the Eyes of the Dead for a very serious interview here on Metal Injection. You guys are about to, you guys just finished recording an album. Is that, that's true. I read it in a press release.
Yes.
And
yes.
You guys recorded with Eric Rutan.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Unfortunately.
Now is it hard? Now was it like, were you guys just in the studio like, wow, this guy, this producer of ours is way more brutal than us. I don't know. Like, was it intimidating to be like,
you know,
Eric listened to a lot of the Cranberries, honestly, to be honest.
And a lot of fucking, what was that band?
Gym Class Heroes.
No. Let's be honest. What was that? That girl, like, she sings.
Evanescence.
Man. Dude, really?
Jam
cranked it up.
Out,
got mad at me when I was like, dude, this sucks.
Yeah, listen to those frequencies,
record,
man. Those
I like
frequencies
Evanescence.
Are amazing.
This is how wide the spectrum of this fucking frequency analyzer. No, he did do that.
He did that a lot.
He really listened to Evanescence. Breaking news on Metal Injection.
Eric Rutan knows a lot about spectrums.
He'd be freaking out over the
and rainbows.
On the
a lot about rainbows.
Yeah, a lot about rainbows.
You know what I mean?
He drinks rainbows?
He drinks a lot of rainbows.
He drinks a sip of Heineken.
So tell us about this new record. What's it called? When's it coming out? Should anybody care about it?
It's called Malice, and it comes out August 21st. And it rules.
So
it's
people
metal.
Should care about
yes,
it.
Yes, it's balls to the wall
fuck
metal.
Yeah.
It's the best record we've done, honestly.
Nate,
like,
how many records have you done?
We've done a split. We've done one full length, a split, an EP. But like, seriously, like.
So like two records.
Well, look, honestly.
Of two records, it's the best one you've done. That's
yes. Listen, like, I know it's cliche of everyone to say, like, our new record's the best. But like, seriously, like, this is like the album that we wanted to write as a band.
Hold on
like,
for 1 second. They're playing Life of Agony Inside, I'm missing it, so. Shit.
It's cool.
Sorry, I haven't heard Life of Agony in a long time.
Now I have a question. If this wasn't the best record you guys put out, why would you put it out?
We wouldn't.
Tu manges beaucoup de bits.
For the record, Steve from Despised Icon mange de bits. Beaucoup de bits. Which in French Canadian means he sucks a lot of dick and not me. Je ne pas mange de bits. I don't suck the dick.
How do you know so much French Canadian?
I learned Left of Mind Distance where we did a tour in Europe with those guys. Yes. It taught me a lot.
Now, is there a difference between French-Canadian and just French? I didn't know it was two different languages.
There is definitely
well,
a difference.
Pretty much when you add Canadian on anything, it sucks.
So it means French.
Yeah! No, just kidding. Actually, some of the best shows on this tour were fucking in Toronto and Montreal.
You fucking anti-American pieces of crap. Why don't you move to Canada? Fucking terrorist supporters.
The broads in Montreal are fucking
Dude.
Smoking.
Dudes are smoking in Montreal.
Yeah. I do not vouch for that. I do not vouch for dudes.
So, what's the lady situation like for Through the Eyes of the Dead? Do you guys get a lot of ladies?
What is the lady situation?
I mean, if I was a single man, I'm sure I'd be getting trim every night. But I have an old lady at home, so I got to take care of her when I'm home.
You go out with old ladies? That's what you're into?
My old lady. No, she's actually younger than I am.
Oh. So, Nate, you used to be in Deadwater Drowning. Earlier I just mentioned it, and Greg from the Red Cord mentioned how you dislike being asked that, so...
That's the greatest question ever! Every fucking night I hear somebody say, Deadwater Drowning!
Yeah,
I just say that every night, like, just so...
He just does it in a different voice every night,
right.
That's what it is.
Now, not really, there isn't.
There was never an official statement as to why you guys broke up, so why don't you just set the record straight?
Well, because we didn't give a fuck, really.
Nice.
No, it was just member changes, people moving, shit like that. Like, it really came down to a lot of just conflicting...
Everything,
basically, yeah.
So it's over. It's never going to happen again.
I would say that. Like, one of the things was, like, our drummer, the original drummer, John, had some issues with, like, where he was living. He couldn't stay up here, and his family moved to Florida, so he's been down there, and he actually been playing a lot of guitar now, and he shreds a guitar. He's probably a better guitarist now than he's a drummer, but you know, we never rule it out as an actual like final show reunion kind of thing. So,
can you guys play in my backyard like next week? Is that cool?
No, not at all.
I'll give you like $5.
No, not for $5.
Ten?
Like 10 kegs maybe.
That can be arranged.
Just for me and Seth though.
All right, deal.
10 kegs per person.
Cool.
We might get a set out of it.
Cool.
Knows.
All right, back to Through the Eyes of the Dead. You guys are still here.
The band.
Yeah.
You want to talk about Pantera or something too? What do you want to
do? Cool. So what are your feelings on, you know, seriously though, you guys, there was a single that you guys put on your MySpace.
Failure in the Flesh.
What was it?
Failure in the Flesh.
Yeah, I liked it. I thought it was good. How do you guys feel about that?
You didn't sound too stoked on it. You don't sound too stoked on it.
I thought it was pleasant.
Not enough silly fucking haircut for you, is that what it is? Just kidding. I know you're wearing a big business shirt. I should have even mentioned funny haircuts.
Yeah, right? I don't know what that means. But
that means nobody going to a big business show should have a stupid haircut because big business rocks.
They do.
Kids with funny haircuts do not rock.
No, they don't. They don't. But are you guys doing anything after this or just hanging out?
Oh, yeah. We're after this tour.
We're gonna get wasted tonight. Have a good night tonight. We're doing a video shoot tomorrow. Then we're gonna.
Oh, that's right. You're doing a video shoot. Apparently. No, I'm not. I have a job. Maybe Frank will be there, but that's neither confirmed nor denied.
Frank's a nice camera, so maybe we should help out with the video.
Well, it's not as nice as Dave's camera. Can you guys tell us the concept of this video? Do you guys even know?
Zombies.
Headbanging.
Headbanging with zombies.
Mayhem.
Who's gonna be playing the zombie?
Dirty in this video, man.
Do we have people playing zombies? I'm not sure.
Yeah, there's like a whole like tomorrow. There's not gonna be any zombies.
Right.
Where will the zombies come from?
They're getting infected right now, actually.
Yeah.
It's a 48-hour grace period before they get infected and they start ravaging shit. So we get to safely record the performance of us, and then the zombie's gonna fucking just destroy shit while we're home safely in our bed sleeping. So
cool. Now you guys know that the place that you're shooting at used to be an old, crazy psych ward type area.
That's what word on the street is, yeah.
And I hear there's a lot of asbestos in there, so you guys might die tomorrow.
Sweet.
You guys looking forward
whatever,
to
life?
Yes!
Whatever happens, man.
Yes!
I'm all about it. Whatever happens.
You know, another thing I heard was David Gilmour of the famous band Pink Floyd, he tried to shoot a video there. They didn't let him. They were like,
really?
They're like, permit denied!
I don't think they were big enough. Maybe.
Oh, yeah. Can I just ask about that? David Gilmour's latest release is an amazing CD.
Is it?
The latest Gilmour? Yeah, it's great. Yeah.
Is it pretty good?
It's good. I liked it, yeah.
Should you smoke before listening to it or after listening to it?
I'm not a smoker, but
there
was some... Here's one thing. If there was some shit that I would smoke to, it would be Pink Floyd or Spacegrass by Clutch.
It only makes sense.
Yeah,
definitely. So, pretty much out of questions. Is there anything you guys want to ask me? Anything like that? Any final words, or should we just end it right here?
No, let's keep it going.
We're going all night long, man.
Enjoying the show?
I think it's pretty good. I'm enjoying myself.
Are you coming to the show tomorrow, or the shoot tomorrow?
I have a job, unfortunately. It's very
lame.
I do web design.
Web design, huh? A lot of porn sites?
Yeah, porn design.
Why not?
Right? You guys were just interviewed by Jasmine St. Clair.
I got something to say. You should check out my buddy Seth's porn site. It's just starting out. Seth from the Acacia's Triennial Basis, pornoutbreak.com.
Plug.
It's still under construction. Yeah, it went up recently. I'm trying to help him out. Pornoutbreak.com.
But were you guys picturing Jasmine St. Clair naked as you were... As you guys
I was actually
were.
Picturing her in a bear suit like you would see at like
hasn't
a,
been a dude back
like
here
a basketball
that hasn't
game.
I haven't
thought it at all.
You're lying.
I mean, like, let's face it, we've all seen her naked at one point.
Exactly.
So,
we've seen her a little worse than naked, let's be honest here. She's like right over there.
I got one thing to say. Good girl, though. Good girl.
Bring her home to dad.
My dad would love her. My God. They don't call my dad Big Johnson for nothing.
Let's wrap this up here. You got
one serious metal injection interview one day, like,
yeah,
seriously.
Maybe.
Probably not.
Maybe.
Show up one day before we actually load in and like.
I have a metal cock. I'm gonna inject all of you with it.
And on that note.
Actually, you know what? Steve from Despised Icons got a little chrome in his dome. You know, the here. That's a metal injection.
He's got a metal plate in his cock.
No, a barbell, I think.
It's a barbell in his cock?
Lifting weights.
Oh, a Prince Albert.
PA, yep. Yeah. Ask him about it. If you guys do an interview, ask him about it.
You probably want to show it to us. I don't want to.
The bruises it gives chicks, man. Like, crotch areas, it's like all purple. And but that could be herpes. I don't know. I've never seen herpes. What?
One of the two.
Like, one, two, yeah. Either way, they don't make bills for that shit.
Let's get to some live footage through the eyes of the dead.
Yeah.
A metal eject.
First. Yeah. Malice.